bought out of Newcastle.
The statue's coming out of his shell a little bit now, Peter.
This is how we expect it to be. And Mitrevski in round four, stepping up the place. But there's Charlie Brown, loves it in close. Watch the head fly here.
Charlie Brown. Keep this pace up.
They certainly can't. Neutral corner now. Once again, Mitrevski, the aggressor, as Charlie Brown covers up, and he does do a good job in that, but more sneaking through in rounds 4, 5, and now 6 than before.
There's about 4 good right hands that Mitrevski's laid on Brown, right on the face.
Yeah, a couple of those lifts they were on, just hitting the gloves, which are there, exactly put up the guarding task from Charlie Brown. And he's sneaking around.
That left hook hurt Mitrevski.
Drops the guard, Charlie Brown, as he chases Peter Mitrevski. Some bombs.
Oh, another right.
Yeah, good right. Charlie Brown, he's hanging on with his left and hitting with the right.
And he's using his head plenty too.
Here another right. And another right. Mitrevski's in a ton of trouble. More trouble than I've seen him in the two fights so far. Yeah, a Charlie Brown going after Peter Mitrevski now in round 6. Charlie Brown giving it his all, but has he taken a lot out of himself? Certainly. Drop the guard, going after Mitrevski.
Oh, in with the head, in with the head. That really is worth a deduction of a point, because he just dives in head first.
He will use what he has, as I said before, Charlie Brown. And in close with Mitrevski, that's a danger area with that head flying around. And another one from Charlie Brown. So, more Liverpool kisses. And he's screaming now, Charlie Brown. He's got a cut over his left eye again.
Down the side of the left eye.
Yes, it is, and Charlie Brown...
He could do that with his own buddy, you know, Peter.
Yeah, he certainly could, and I would have
another one.
Oh, another headbutt. This is us.
He's going to get disqualified.
Dangerous round, this one. And another headbutt there.
Yes,
Too much.
Yes, and he's won.
He's disqualified Charlie Brown.
And Brown wants to go on with it again, but really, really, Peter, that was what boxing shouldn't be about.
And we're joined now by Peter Mitrevski. And Peter, I gather that you and Charlie Brown don't swap Christmas cards, mate.
No, we don't. Charlie's all right.
So do you still keep in contact with him at all?
No, I don't. I've seen him a few of the fights and always say hello to him. Yeah, he's all right.
Your head must have been a bit sore after that, was it?
Yeah, it was, yeah.
Man, I still look sore today, Peter, to be quite honest.
That looks all right, Jeff.
Now, of course, Pete, you in your own right were quite an accomplished fighter. You won 3 national titles. You must have been pretty proud of yourself.
Yeah, I was. I mean, it's something that only 5 people in the Australian boxing history have done, and I'm very proud of it.
And, of course, one of the men that you did fight went on to win the world title, and it was at one stage you were going to fight him for the world title.
Yeah, well, they fought a draw. Peter and Manny Milton fought a draw at the Enmore Theatre, and very great fight, and honestly, it's been Peter's friend, but I was there, and I thought that Peter would have got the decision that day, but then Manny went on to accomplish the top of the mountain, and Peter lost a little bit of fire then, and I can't believe that, you know, that day he was just so close to being world champion again. He was rated number 4 in the world, and then Peter had a great career, and, you know, my career was long and great, but I couldn't have done what I'd done without the help of my best mate here, every morning running with me, training with me, and, you know, this guy's one of the fittest guys that ever, you know, stepped in the ring, and without doubt had much of the biggest heart.
Yeah, now, Pete, you have known Jeff all of your life. You're a little bit older than him, I remember reading him.
Jesse's older than me.
Yeah, I'm looking to...
Yeah, looking great ears on him,
Now, I understand that you actually, from reading the biography, that you used to belt Jeff up when he was young, is that right?
Well, I gave him a bashing a couple of times. We were at a shop playing pinball and he threw in my machine, so I gave him a bashing one time, I remember.
As I say, it was a difference in Asia when you're 10 and somebody's like 20. They can kind of put over you those days, but I certainly even a score back in the sparring when I grew up and we started the box together. And, you know, if anything, I apologise to Peter's parents for the way he is today.
Oh, mate, that's not what we hear. We hear it's the other way also in the gym.
Well, you know, stories fly and you hear rumours and you hear people talk about themselves. But like I said, I'd like to publicly apologise to Peter's parents and to anybody that has to, you know, spend long periods of time with him, because you forget things and stuff. And I had to get him driven to the door and walked in here this morning because of them. A thing that we call leather poisoning that Peter attracted over the years of sparring with me.
And I would like to apologise to Jeff about his, and to Susie about his nose. Have a look at his nose. That's from copying this from me all the time.
Now, Pete, just on a serious note, of course, growing up with Jeff, you would have seen his talent as a boxer develop. Did you realise when he was young that he would go on to be so good?
Well, when I first seen him spar at the gym and that, and I mean, Jeff's such a, like, got so much fitness and everything, such a strong kid, and I realised that he was going to be a world champion. When he first told me that he was fighting for a world title, I couldn't believe it was so quick.
Yeah.
Although he realised I was going to be a world champion, he still thought he could beat me. He thought, if he's going to be a world champion, that's great, I'll just take it off him.
Well, it was my dream to be a world champion, so, you know, I did. That was the reason I trained so hard, and I wanted to be a world champion, but didn't get there.
And now, of course, you're in the corner of Kostya Zou, one of the best world champions at the moment. Is that good? You must enjoy that, Terry.
Yeah, I do. That's great. You know, being in the corner with Kostya Zou, and I reckon Kostya Zou, there's nobody out there that'll beat him. He's just a little dynamite.
What's it like actually being in his corner during in-between rounds? Is there a lot said?
Well, Johnny Lewis, when we get in the corner and give him a drink, and Johnny Lewis does a bit of talking, and when he's fighting and that, and I usually try to scream out and say things to Costa, but it's great. I enjoy doing it, and Costa's one of the best fighters we're going to see for a long time come out of Australia.
And what else are you up to?
I've also drive a truck for a living and also doing some building.
That's right. Aren't you involved with Jeff in that?
Oh, no, Peter done his own man development. He's done really, really well, and it's good to see that somebody who obviously didn't make a lot of money out of the sport and like I said, it doesn't have all these marbles left, can go on to be so successful in business. Sorry, Pete.
We might put a fight on now.
Oh, look at him carrying away.
The gloves are there.